Coming back to the point, as I said, accounting is a process of recording all financial transactions, right? We really need to understand what it means by a transaction. We know in general what a transaction is. Transaction is nothing but you give something and you take something, that's a transaction. But there are few bits within the transactions that you need to understand, which I'm going to talk about now. So what is a transaction? In the business language, a transaction is an agreement between a buyer and a seller. This agreement is for exchange of goods or exchange of services in return for money or something valuable. Primarily, it is about money when it comes to business. So now let's say you sold your car to a person named John for $2,000. Okay. Now, what you've done is you exchange your car for $2,000 from your perspective, right? And from John's perspective, he exchanged his money for your car. So if you observe carefully, there are two events happening when something is being exchanged. And from our perspective, the car went out and money came in. From John's perspective, money went out and car came in. So a transaction would have four events if you consider the different perspectives. But in business, we would always look things from our perspective. This is a gap, okay? Because sometimes we will not be able to understand whether something is a credit or something is a debit. So when you look at from your perspective, something is credited or something is debited. But if you look at from other person's perspective, the opposite would have happened, okay? So it is important to observe things from our perspective. Now, if I have to elaborate the question, what is accounting? Accounting is nothing but recording all these exchanges that happen within the business as and when they happen. The key point to remember is as and when they happen, we need to record them, okay? And then we summarize all of these transactions or all of these exchanges that are happening in the business in statements over a period of time. Now, why do we need to summarize these transactions? Just imagine the number of transactions that a multi-billion dollar business can have. If you take all these financial transactional records without summarizing them in their raw format and give it to the investors or the government authorities, then they would have to spend their entire life trying to figure out which transaction is what and whether the company has made any profits or not. And the sole reason why I need to summarize them into different financial statements or different financial records is just to make them easy to understand for others. And there are certain standards that we need to follow while we summarize them. But we also need to know how often do we need to summarize them.